Welcome to the Kepler IO Academy, where industry experts share tips and tricks on working with data. In this video, we'll show you how to use the most common Power BI visuals. Hi there, I'm Crystal. Power BI can feel overwhelming with the amount of charts available right out of the gate, so I thought I'd make the task easier for you. I've picked about a dozen of the most popular types of visuals in Power BI, and I'm going to show them to you one by one with practical examples. So let's get straight to it then. To get data for my report, I used Kepler.io, a platform that turns complex data into simple reports. You can use it to automate data imports to Power BI from over 70 apps on a fully automated basis. I'll work with a data set of advertising campaigns that I fetched from 7 PPC platforms. And here's the imported data set in Microsoft Power BI. In the meantime, I created a date table to get more out of the date field present in my data set. And I created 2 measures that will also prove useful in some Power BI visuals. So let's jump to the report page. The charts reside in the visualizations pane to the right. The first of the standard Power BI visuals that I want to show you is a card. Cards represent a single aggregated metric. For example, I'll drag and drop clicks and the card will immediately display the sum of clicks obtained by my campaigns. Let's move it to the side and I'll add one more card. This time, let's take CPC or cost per click. Summing it up doesn't really make sense, so I'd better change the aggregation method to average. That's much better, but the visual side of the card needs an improvement. Every visual in Power BI has a format tab where you can adjust the look of a chart and plenty more. For cards, the options are limited to formatting a category label and a callout value. Here, I can choose to display precisely 2 decimals, which will make my card a lot more readable right away. Power BI cards can be resized so you can fit plenty of them on your Power BI report, but you can also consider a multi-row card visual. This chart displays multiple metrics, so let's add once again clicks, CPC, and also CPM, the cost per 1,000 impressions. As you can see, you can also click on the checkboxes next to the respective fields to add them to a chart. Microsoft Power BI will guess where they make the most sense. Sometimes it may not guess it right, but here it really can't go wrong. Let's adjust the aggregation method for the cost-related metrics. In the same way I did before, you can also adjust the number of decimals and more. I'll clean the canvas and move on to another standard Power BI visual, a table. Tables can accept categorical dimensions like campaigns or countries that data is grouped by, as well as metrics that are aggregated. You add them all into the columns bucket. I'll go ahead with a list of my campaigns, impressions, clicks, and conversions. Let's expand the visual a bit. Often it makes sense to adjust the field's names for better readability. And now I can shrink the chart again. To sort Power BI tables, hover on a column you want to sort by and click on a triangle that pops up. Once or twice, whether you need to sort in an ascending or descending order. There are plenty of formatting options available for tables. You can choose from one of the style presets. I'll also enable a vertical grid, which will make my chart even more readable. A more advanced version of a table is a matrix, also known as a pivot table on other platforms. A Power BI matrix lets you display data across multiple dimensions at the same time. Let's see it in action. I'll keep campaigns as a row dimension and add a segment of the market that we target with ads as a row dimension. A matrix can accept and aggregate multiple values, but for the sake of simplicity, I'll limit values to just 1. And here's a ready Power BI matrix. You can see the number of impressions for each campaign for each segment separately. The next group of charts I want to show you are bar and column charts, 6 of which reside at the top of the list. I'll start with a bar chart. To the y-axis, I'll add a platform that we advertise on, and to the x-axis, let's add clicks. There's also a 100% variant of this chart, but it doesn't really make sense with the current setup. To make use of it, I need to add at least 1 more field to the mix and drop it into the legend bucket. Now you can see the split of clicks for each platform and can, for example, deduct that Bing ads perform pretty well in the real estate segment. Column charts work identically, the only difference being their orientation. Here's a stacked column chart with the same data. There's also a clustered column chart that builds separate columns for each value, and it's equivalent with bars. As an option, you can drop the breakdown dimension like segment into the small multiples bucket below. This will create separate columns or bar charts for each of the values in the segment column. The next data visualization method on my list is a Power BI line chart. I want to use it to visualize the clicks that our campaigns attracted. I want to compare data month to month, so onto the x-axis, I'll drop the year-month field. On the y-axis, I'll put the sum of clicks. The chart at the moment doesn't make much sense as the values are sorted by clicks descending. It's hard to spot any fluctuations. To fix it, I can adjust sorting and I'll choose to sort by the year-month field and will do so in ascending order. This pushed the latest results to the rightmost side of the chart. Another issue is that labels on the x-axis aren't really readable. What can help here is adjusting the category width in the layout settings. Let's set it to 37 pixels, and now the visual looks much better. You can drag more fields onto the y-axis, but you'll want to make sure that the values are on somewhat similar levels. I have much fewer conversions than clicks, so the line for the former looks rather difficult to interpret at first glance. Luckily, there's an option to put conversions on a secondary y-axis, which I will gladly take advantage of. You can also do some Power BI forecasting with a line chart. Let's give it a try. Forecasting will only work with a single value on the y-axis, so let's get rid of conversions. Also, it seems I need to have individual dates on the x-axis for the forecasting to work, so let's swap the fields here. The chart is a bit messy now with all the individual data points, so I'll add a filter limiting data to only the last 60 days. Now, I head to the third tab focused on analytics and enable the forecast. You'll see the gray area appear to the right of my chart, indicating the range that Power BI forecasts for future click values. Nothing really groundbreaking in this case, but I hope you get the idea. You can tweak the forecast, for example, by increasing the forecast length or adjusting the confidence interval. Afterwards, click Apply and the chart will update right away. Okay, let's disable this feature because I want to show you another Microsoft Power BI visual where you can also use a line chart. One of them is a line and stacked column chart. As the name suggests, it combines two charts we have already seen before. I'll keep the date field and the columns representing clicks. I'll also add two line charts, one for the sum of conversions and another for the average CPC. Try also the line and clustered column chart that works in a similar fashion. The next data visualization method you'll often come across is a Power BI area chart. It's commonly used to show changes over time and how different values contribute to the overall result. I'll drop the year-month field onto the x-axis and display impressions on the other axis. Let's tweak the charts like I did before for better readability. Now the area chart tells me how impression numbers changed every month, but this is something I could also learn from a simple line chart. The chart becomes much more insightful once you add another dimension to the mix. Although a lot is going on with the chart now, you can see clearly which channels contributed the most impressions in either month. For example, April was the month of Facebook ads, while a month before, LinkedIn ads had the best result. And if you're interested in the total values for each month, as well as individual contributions, try the stacked area chart instead. Another type of visuals in Power BI that's worth knowing is a waterfall chart. This chart shows a running total for a chosen metric, letting you see what contributes to the overall goal in either a positive or negative way, or how data changes over time. To demonstrate it, I'll use the year column. I'll set segment as a breakdown category and we'll put the sum of ROI, or return on investment, onto the y-axis. Let's expand, sort by the date field, and have a look at what we got. The blue columns indicate the total ROI for a given year. Notice that the x-axis doesn't start at zero, so the values for 2022 and 2023 aren't actually as bad as they seem. The green columns indicate growth, and here you can see that in the real estate segment, our ROI fell by almost 4% as compared to the previous year. Luckily, we more than made up for it with huge growth in the other two segments, so all in all, it was a good year. Another visualization type is a Power BI funnel chart. It's used as a data visualization method for any kind of flows. In paid advertising, there's one obvious flow that I want to demonstrate. I want to see the number of impressions, clicks, and conversions in that order to see where users drop out of the funnel. For better readability, I'll adjust the labels' names, and let's also change the display units and add the conversion rates from the previous stage. Based on what I got, I can see that our conversion to clicks, also known as CTR, can definitely use an improvement. On the other hand, once users click on an ad, they convert at a fairly decent rate. Well done, team! The next of the standard Power BI visuals that I wanted to show you is a scatter chart. This chart shows a relationship between two numerical fields that you place on the X and Y axis. Let's see it in action. I want to analyze campaigns in terms of the impressions they generate. I'll put campaigns into the value bucket, impressions on the x-axis, and CPM, the cost per 1,000 impressions, on the y-axis. An average aggregation method would make sense for both. Looking at the right side, I can see that the winter discount campaign was seen by a lot of people, and it didn't cost us much. The same is true for the Black Friday sale that I have below. The impressions were great and the CPM is spectacularly low. Nice. On the other hand, the spring promotion in the top left corner, as well as the two other campaigns nearby, didn't attract much attention and cost quite a lot. There's certainly a field for improvement. And if you're up for some animated Power BI visuals, I've got something for you too. The scatter chart is one of Power BI visuals with a play axis. Drop a field there and press the play button, and you'll see an animation with dots popping up one by one. Enjoy! Okay, the next visual I wanted to show you is a Power BI pie chart. It's pretty straightforward. I want to see if there's a day of the week when users click more often on my ads, so I'll add the day of week onto the legend bucket. And the average clicks I'll set as values. Let's sort by days of the week for an easier analysis. And it turns out that slices of a pie are just about the same for every weekday. Well, it was worth trying. You can add more data to a pie chart by dropping it into the segment bucket. Now I can see that on Tuesdays, campaigns targeted at the e-commerce segment record a rather low number of clicks. Maybe I should run more ads on Wednesday then. A variant of a pie chart that differs solely by the look is a donut chart. Here it is. Let's move on to the next one, and it will be a colorful one. Ladies and gentlemen, I present you a Power BI Treemap visual. I drop campaigns onto the category bucket and an average CTR onto values. What I can do right away is enable data labels, which will display an average CTR for each campaign right next to its name. The bigger the rectangle, the higher the value it represents, with the top performers nested in the top left corner of a chart. So here we have the Cyber Monday deal campaign that I just complained about while discussing the scatter chart. It may not be attracting many impressions, but the conversion rate it generates is top notch. On the opposite side is the Black Friday sale, which certainly should do better. All right, now let's have a look at some Power BI maps. There's a standard map visual, a filled map, more advanced Azure maps, as well as ArcGIS maps for Power BI. Lots to choose from. I'll go with the standard map chart. To use maps, you'll need to have at least one geographic field in your data source. I have a target country that depicts a country that our ads are targeted at. On this map, I want to see which countries attract the most impressions, so I'll drop impressions onto the bubble size bucket. let's also adjust the visual side of the charts. You can choose from several style presets. I'll choose the dark theme and we'll also add zoom and lasso buttons. Below, adjust the bubble size so it's clearer which countries attract the most impressions. You can also add more data to the chart, and I'll add platform to the legend bucket, which will turn bubbles into pie charts for each country. I can now see the impression numbers for each platform separately. If you prefer, try the filled map visual or other more advanced maps. And last but not least, the Power BI KPI chart. The visual is a combination of a gauge chart demonstrating progress towards a goal and time series chart showing how data changes over time. To demonstrate some meaningful data on this chart, I previously created two measures that contain our revenues for this and the last year. So I'll put the data for this year into the value bucket, and the target will be our results for the last year. I'll draw the trend axis using the month field. It seems we're on the right track, already surpassing last year's results by over 2%. Nice. In the background, you can see the trend line showing revenue changes month to month, but not all goals are the same. Sometimes, for example, in cost-related metrics, the lower the value, the better. You can adjust that in the format settings, and the chart will adapt right away. By the way, if you don't have a suitable field to be set as target, you can create goals by adding an Excel workbook to your data model or a PBIX file. And these were all Power BI visualizations that I wanted to show you today, but there's a lot more available for you to use. There's, of course, a slicer that lets users filter data and makes Power BI charts more dynamic. The gauge chart that I just mentioned tells you how far you are from reaching your goals, or build custom visualizations in R or Python and insert them onto your dashboard. The sky's the limit. If that wasn't enough, there are also hundreds of custom visuals in Power BI developed mostly by third-party developers. However, exercise caution when adding them to your most important reports, as they're not as reliable as standard Power BI visuals. And that's it. Now you know much more about Power BI visuals, but if you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a like, share the video with others, and subscribe to our channel so you never miss a thing. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.